You know, man broke me, you cannot break me. The words of Jean-Guy McCroy in his Eurovision 2021 song, Birth of a New Age. He has given several interviews about the song explaining the meaning, and here's what he told Vogspot. The song is about many different things. You can look around and think the world is collapsing, it is all going awry, and there are all these tensions. But I see all kinds of people around me standing up for themselves and standing up for who they are, them taking back the respect and space they deserve. That inspires me and gives me the feeling that it all will be fine. There are people that are using their voice to change things so it will be better for everyone else. You guys, that is his meaning. The question is it resonating with you? Should we talk about it? Let's do this! Yes, Jean-Guy McCroy is giving birth to Birth of a New Age. His Eurovision 2021 song is so authentic to him. He is using the gorgeous language of Suriname, the country of his birth, the country where he found his voice, found his instruments. He told us in an interview that he was writing the song wanting to honor his homeland, the nation that made him. This song is so, what's the word, honest. This is so honest to Jean-Guy. Other artists, I think, worry about, oh, will this do well on the scoreboard? Oh, will this be a radio hit? This was clearly about producing something that meant something to him. This is authenticity in its purest form. You know, the result, eh, who knows? The host country always struggles. I don't think this is obviously an instant radio hit. I don't think this is the type of song that people are gonna rush to vote for. However, I think people will be touched. I think people will be impressed by his voice, and I think people will feel his honesty, the freedom, in what must be one of the loosest songs of the year. And I mean that in the sense of, it's not trying to fit in anyone else's box. It's fitting in Jean-Guy's box, and what a gorgeous box that is. Robin in New Zealand, what do you think?
If I listen to the song and just the audio alone, it doesn't quite feel complete. It feels like I'm listening to like a song from a musical, and it's like, okay, that's cool, but what's happening on stage? And that is borne out by whenever I watch the music video or the live performance he did at the reveal, that feels a lot more complete and it really comes together. And that's a really interesting thing, because I mean, Eurovision, we call it a song contest, but it is a TV show. It's always been a TV show. It's always been about the visuals. So I think, you know, if you're going through listening on Spotify, it, like for me at least, it can feel a little incomplete. But then the live performance brings so much more. And it's not even just context. It just sort of feels like this is meant to be this performance with you sitting and watching the performer. There is the whole thing about, you know, countries don't always do as well when they're hosting, and I think it's because they're not necessarily focused on winning that year. But in this case, I don't know. I don't think this song is necessarily going to do really badly, but regardless of what its result is at Eurovision, it doesn't really need to. It's just this really amazing, uplifting performance, and it's so different from the rest of the songs in the lineup this year. It's just, I feel like a really welcome addition to the lineup. I'm really happy with it.
Devin Adoremi, WeebyBlogs.com.
You know, I mean, a lot of people, a lot of artists who perform at Eurovision use that opportunity to showcase national culture, flavor, mood. But Jean-Guy is going beyond that, because what he's doing is sort of packaging cross-cultural communication in 3 minutes. The struggle for emancipation here is real. There is a lot of change. We are on the cusp of lots of changes. There's the Black Lives Matter movement, which of course we all know about, but there's also changes happening in the Netherlands as well. Sylvana Simmons was elected the very first political party, black female political party leader. There's the Zwarte Piet, the face painting thing, which is again being debated, and you know, numbers are shifting. But also back home where he's from in Paramaribo, there's a lot of change as well. Daisy Balthazar is out of power, and you now have a leader who is restoring law and order, because he's the he was the minister of I think it was the chief of police. There's a lot going here, and you've only got 3 minutes to express that. And I feel like Jean-Guy McCroy is the artist that has truly been the most introspective, and put out 3 minutes of sort of like, it feels like a documentation of a journey. You see, again, this is the sort of artist he is, because Grow, whilst you said something earlier that host countries do struggle, blah, 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 I agree. But I think Grow, had the contest gone ahead last year, was really challenging for a trophy. But, you know, this, I feel, isn't doing that. But at the same time, it's taking on a bigger role, a bigger task. History in the making, Boo. This is the first time ever that Stranantongo, the language of Suriname, which is a mixture of English, Dutch, Creole, it's, you know, it's the first time you're ever going to hear it at the Eurovision Song Contest. It's taken a long time, but you're going to hear it this year. This is great. There's so much here that I love. The honesty is empowering. It is layered. It is complex. It is also musical. You talk about musical theatre. Yes, I hear those comparisons too. Jean-Guy McCroy is an artist I want to journey with. And I'm so glad he's back. It's not your radio hit. It's your visual hit. Music, again, has moved on. If you think about Solange's When I Get Home, it's a visual package. It's a visual package. It's not just an audio file. And, you know, lots of new artists like FKA Twigs, again, you know, visual packages, Natasha Kills, visual packages. I think the visuals are very important here. And he's slaying with that. Not just the music video, which is, by the way, another interesting documentation of intercultural expression. So his live performance, because when he performs, he brings new dimensions, new layers, new meanings, new discoveries, new emotions even. Suzanne, I don't know where you're at, but I'm loving this.
Suzanne, quick lyrical interlude to set you up. They spat on your crown and they poisoned your ground. Your rhythm is rebellion. They burned your heroes at the stake, but your voice will echo all their names. This ain't the end, no. It's the birth of a new age.
I have always been one for the underdog in response to you setting me up, William. Thank you so much. So, this song is clearly about repression. The first thing I thought when I heard the name of the song, Birth of a New Age, was just how globally the world has changed. It's been such an interesting 14 to 15 months since we began 2020. I don't think anything went quite as any of us would have planned. So it's definitely the birth of a new age. We had the coronavirus pandemic, we had all of the Black Lives Matters incidents, then you layer on AAPI, the anti-Asian incidents. It all just has come together to really create a new age. I actually said to a friend the other day, will this be for the better, or behind the scenes, will there suddenly be something for the worse, which is interesting because we never know what's really going on in the world behind the scenes. And so it's all really just a little bit scary. But I really love the way he talks about the birth of a new age. There's something very tribal, very spiritual about this, being burned at the stake, burying your gods. The fact that you move is rebellion, you know, you will persevere for another day. And I really do love that whole concept. I love the way he tied it back to his roots. And then it had one of those recurring themes that I think really resonates for all of us. We are all one. And you see all of the different ethnicities and you hear the different sounds. If I could have chosen a musical interlude for myself, William, it would have varied from what you chose. So my favorite portion of the song is how it ends. It's the birth of a new age. We are the fruit, adorning the legacy of every forgotten revolutionary, born in resilience, proud like a lion. We are the birth of a new age. And I love the song. It has grown on me every time I've listened to it.
Well, it's really interesting you bring up that line. That's my favorite musical part, because there's a lot of rhythm there. We are the fruit, adoring the legacy of every forgotten revolutionary. There's like a rhythm and flow there. The whole final minute of this song, to me, that is so, I don't know, it just wakes me up. It jolts me into sort of a rebellious mood. Funny enough, I'm reading this on weeweeblogs.com. This line about the forgotten revolutionary could refer to the fact that in 2020, the revolutionary Anton de Combes became the first Surinamese-born historical figure added to the canon of the Netherlands, a list of the 50 most important topics or persons in Dutch history. He was a man who led resistance efforts against the Dutch colonialists. So there you go. Again, to Devin's point, the song could touch on so many different historical moments, periods, feelings. I actually asked Jean-Gu about your point about the regime change in Suriname, and he said he wasn't thinking about that. However, it does fit, because again, all this stuff is in the atmosphere, just kind of swirling, and he was giving birth to this song in this atmosphere. In terms
but
of...
But also, you have to bear in mind that narratives don't always... it's like Jamala, classic 1944. No, it's not a political entry. No, it's like, you know, subsequently, then you know it is. Nina Sublati, you know, from Georgia, again, you know, the whole thing about Warrior, you know, it's just a 3-minute pop song. But actually, years later on, we discover that being oximated has a lot more to do with border controls with Russia. So, you know, what he's saying here is, okay, my focus is here. But I wouldn't take that on board 100%. I think that, you know, a lot of songs and, you know, revelations are not always 100% match to the songs that people write. And but even let's even assume that I'm to believe what Jean-Gu says. Music does touch on people in different ways. What you are trying to communicate, I may receive something else from it. So, yeah, but it's a good thing, I think, that it also references where he comes from. Because the birth of a new age, I mean, I think there was actually a political headline, birth of a new age, when Daisy Balthasar left power. That was like, you know, a headline, a newspaper headline. But yeah.
He told us in our interview as well that he's going to take advantage of the pre-recorded backing vocals to include the choir. Because obviously in a normal year, you couldn't do that. You need the 5 backing vocalists max. But he's like, no, no, no. We've recorded it. It's going to be epic. Plus, we will also have live backing vocalists. So he'll be mixing. So expect a wall of sound. The music video is so stunning, so high fashion. He said that he mixed Surinamese clothing with sort of a modern twist. It's very high fashion. It's just glorious. We see all sorts of beautiful people doing all, you know, resisting, fighting, slaying, serving. Final point, musical theater. This is the dawning of the age of Aquarius. Do y'all remember this musical? The hippies. Yes. I get that vibe here, and that's a really good thing, because that's like a timeless musical. I think that with epic staging, this could come mid-table. I think this could reach 15, 16 with really epic staging. Without the epic staging, though, I do worry that perhaps the sound is too original, too unique for, you know, the average Eurovision viewer. But I'm hopeful. I think the home nation, which knows the stage better than anyone else, because they've had it for 2 years, is going to know how to work with it and know how to play with it. So I'm feeling good. Robin.
Yeah, I'd say about that, about mid-table. Yeah, and I also agree that it would need to be elevated by really epic staging. And yeah, like it is the home team. They're not going to be concerned about, you know, not leaving the country because they're already there. I can see them just really not necessarily going all out in a way that like a country that really wanted to win Eurovision would, but just you know, going, okay, we're here, it's the home entry, let's just do something really special. So if they do that, if they bring it, it's really going to elevate it and it could do really well.
Declan?
It's a really tough one for me because I'm hoping for mid-table, but I'm not even sure we'd get mid-table just because, you know, people sort of in a really festive, joyous mood, they may take a minute just to even work it out. And then another 2 minutes. I mean, there's a lot that is packed in here. And it is light for what it tries to do, but it is still a strong Eurovision flavor. I don't know, Robin, have I said something? yeah. Do you understand what I mean, though? Like, it packs a lot in a very light way, but for Eurovision, it would still be considered quite heavy and quite strong. And I hope it does well. Again, I'm going to hope for mid-table, but I wouldn't be surprised if it doesn't even hit that. But the good news here is, and I'm sure this informs Zhangu's thinking, you know, he had a great song, Grow, which, by the way, our readers haven't heard it. I'm sure they have, but go check it out. Great song, Grow. Eurovision got cancelled. He's got to come again. He's automatically in the grand final. So he's now probably thinking, I want to make an impact. And sometimes impact is not always short term. This will live on. And this is the beauty of that. You know, I think, you know, mission accomplished here. Destiny fulfilled.
Suzanne.
I really like The Birth of a New Age. However, I'm just not sure that it's going to be a fan favorite. Okay. As far as overall placement, I think it's a good song. Like, I didn't rate it middle of the road, but...
Well, it is now time to go around and give our scores out of a 10, along with a brief explanation. I will kick this off. I respect him as an artist, as a vocalist, as a performer. I think he looks great. He's got a great artistic sensibility. The music video shows all of this and more. In the past, he's really tackled the issue of Dutch colonialism, the legacy of slavery. A lot of issues connect to colonialism. Again, nothing but respect. He's getting at that here as well. You know, when you read the lyrics in that context, it really is about standing up, you know, emancipation, freedom. My score is a 6.5. This is not in any way shade. It's just recognizing that perhaps, you know, without the visuals, you know, as an audio cut, perhaps it's not something I would loop on Spotify, but I do not deny the quality. I do not deny the power of the artist or the potential with amazing staging and visuals to really bring this to life, as we saw in the music video. Wishing him all the best. Robin.
Yeah, my score is 7. Like I've said this before, I'm quite frugal with my really, really high scores, but like this is a good performance. He's a really talented, charismatic artist. He is sure to bring, based on what we've seen with his other live performances, he's sure to bring the same sort of energy and uplifting spirit to the Eurovision Grand Final. So, yeah, it's going to be good.
I'm going to echo Robin and say I'm equally frugal with my high scores. I don't have a 10 this year. I don't even have a 9.5. I'm giving Zhangu McCroy a 7. And another point which I'd like to bring up is that I love, you know, there's the whole obvious emancipation, you know, slavery, the colonial ties of the Netherlands to Suriname. But beyond that, there's also a non-binary feel to his visuals. And I think that's just wonderful. The music video and his stage performance, there's just this flamboyance, this celebration of gender expression, and I think that's just absolutely wonderful. It feels really inclusive. Like, you know, slavery and colonialism can be uncomfortable topics to talk about because essentially you're saying that you've done this to me, you know. But I don't get that from his song. I don't get that from his video. I just get a sense of, I'm half a cent, you know. You can't break me in the same way I can't break you. We can't be broken as individuals. We can't be broken as marginalized people. We can't be, you know, let's just all come together. Let's enjoy this rebirth and this explosion of life. And I think that is absolutely wonderful.
Suzanne.
I rated Birth of a New Age with also a seven. What I'm hearing from this song is it's really time to just open up our hearts. I like the song, and again, it grows on me each time I hear it. I have a tendency to really like songs that belong in musicals. I was rather thinking Hamilton when I listened to this song, just because of the history spin on it. So my score was a seven.
Well, we were rather consistent in our scoring, but what happens when we call on the dozens of other movie bloggers all around the world, from Australia to the Netherlands, via the United States, Colombia, and Portugal? Robin, of course, in New Zealand, has been overseeing this process. She calculated this number using her abacus, and the overall global average is 6.86. So again,
Wow.
very consistent with what we've got here. Interesting. Robin, what do you make of that?
Yeah, it seems, there are some people who've given it a 10. There was someone else who gave it a 1.5. So, there's a bit of a range there. But yeah, just generally, people have been giving it those mid-level, sort of upper mid-level scores. So, yeah, I think that average is a good reflection of how Webby bloggers in general are feeling about it.
In any case, that's what we think. What do you think? Are you living for Monsieur Jean-Guy McCroy? How do you think this is gonna do in the final? Does it grow to you? Is someone going into labor, giving birth to a new age? Let us know here on Weebie Vlogs.
And don't forget to subscribe to stay in touch with all our latest videos.
And don't forget to visit all of our social media platforms. Comment, like, subscribe, share the way we share with you. What are those social media platforms, Devin?
Pinterest is the one that matters, so please make sure you follow us
You know
for all
what?
things.
Let's not forget MySpace, Friendster, OnlyFans, all the other places you'll find us this day and age. And we will see you later. Bye.